I told you not to attack us. Don't say I didn't warn you. Arr. That's right, it's me, Scryptar. How you doing, folks? I'm over here. I'm doing great. We're back with another episode of ARK Survival Evolved. Now, I hope you liked the last montage. We got some work done, right? We got the fences set up down there. We got our Archie, which we desperately need to tame more dinosaurs. And that is what we're going to do this episode. We need to start work on the foundations in there, but before we do that, we need a couple more things done. We have our Dodic, so we can get stone fairly easily. We still need something for wood and something for thatch. So for wood, we have the option of getting a mammoth. Let me get my hut back here. Or of getting a beaver. Now, mammoth is beneficial to us because mammoth is just around the corner, you know? We can get it right there in the snow biome. There's loads of mammoth over there. So it should be fairly easy to get. Then again, snow biome, we don't really have anything to protect us against the cold yet. For that, we actually need to kill mammoth. So it's kind of a controversial thing. Come on, level up here. As for a beaver, we need to go a little ways out to get a beaver. But then, a beaver is better than a mammoth at gathering resources. You don't need to pump weight as much because wood actually doesn't weigh as much when carried by a beaver. And the saddle of a beaver functions as a smithy. So we have a mobile smithy and a mobile wood storage if we actually get a beaver. So I think that's what we're going to do. For thatch, best I can think of at the moment is the Megaloceros, the giant prehistoric elk, if you wish. Or reindeer, call it what you like, I don't really mind. It's a thatch machine. That's, we all know that, it's a thatch machine. So we're gonna get one of those. So what I'm trying to do is see if I can find those, find a nice spot to tame them, maybe even lure them in here. Because they can't get out once we close the door, right? So let me have a look around, see if I find some. And then I'll be right back. And we're back. I kind of found one. It's level 116 again. So I was flying over the snow biome here. It's really easy to do. Just fly down this, well, empty area. You know, no trees, no nothing. You see a lot of them. I mean, there's one down there, which is like level 20 or something, I think. Yeah. And there's another 16, and some were getting killed by rexes and by wolves and whatnot. I found this one being marked by 8 wolves. I got it just in the nick of time. That's where the Archie comes in handy. Just pick it up, take it home. So I'm gonna take this one home and put it down. I'm not gonna be able to tame that one just now. Look at how bloody that is. If I try to shoot that, it will die. So I'm gonna put it down and wait for it to heal up, which will take some time. And in the meantime, I will go looking for a beaver. If we are not able to tame this one, because it just takes too long, I'll try and see if I can find another one. There was a level 68, which would be good enough. Something, you know, 70 upwards is always good. At least, looking at where we are in the game, we are not able to do perfect tames. We don't have kibbles, we don't have the vegetables growing and all of that, and it will still take some time. Before we can start growing vegetables with this setup, we are going to have one or the other vault set up, and for that we still need a couple of level. You will find out why that is as described once we get there. So you stay here, you close, you're trying to run out. Well, somebody should have told you where the gate is then. Now, since I've taken this one out of its habitat quite a ways, you've seen how far it took us to get here, it might despawn when we're away. So if you have a real multiplayer server, not what I've set up here for this series, then usually that should be no problem, because there's always somebody around, right? So this area stays loaded, nothing really should happen here. I just hope it doesn't despawn. If it does, we get a new one. So, I'm going to fly down the coast here. And probably around to the bottom center. So what is that? 9058. That's where you definitely find beavers. There's other spot on the map. Just check the wiki. It shows you where to find them. Sometimes there are some along this coastline as well. They're pretty rare, though. If I find something worth taming, I'll meet you right back. Well, found a level 56 female. If you look at the competition that I find usually, 28, that's actually quite high. What are you? Yeah, that's what I usually find. Level 8, level 4, level 12, and a Rex. I've been killing Rexes along the way. It's quite fun if they are not too high of a level. We made some levels on this bird. It's 201. We got it at what? What's your name? Does it show the name? Oh, no, that's not the right menu. That's the right menu. 172. So we made about 30 levels. I've been pumping movement speed, a little bit of weight. I've got health up to 5,000. Could be, well, yeah, it could be 10,000, but I leave it at 5,000 for the moment. This is going to be a speed bird. And we need this to go way higher. At only 2.5 per level, this will take some time. As you can also see, been through the swamp, found a land species X guarded by snakes and bugs and whatnot. That was my first like 10 levels in 15 seconds. And I've been plundering some beaver dams along the way whenever I killed those pesky little level 4s. And I can't do that just now, because then I would have to drop this guy, which I'm not going to do. So I'm going to fly down the river here towards the volcano. Let's have a quick look at the map. I've been... We're over here, right? Right there. I've been down here, over there. I've been checking this area, nothing really important. Checking this area, 3 or 4 level 4 and 8s. So that's where I got most of the cementing paste from those beaver dams. While flying over here in the swamp, that's where I found plant species X. And then I went through all of this, checked this area, and here is where I actually found the guy I'm currently carrying around. And well, you've seen that, now we just did this crossing. Sometimes they are beavers here, and I will check the lake up here as well, and then we're going straight back home. I know what you're saying, this does not look like a beaver, right? On our way home at the very edge of the swamp, I found this frog and I just couldn't resist. However, I managed to drop the beaver first. There she is. And over there. You're still here. That's gorgeous. Healing up nicely, still quite bloody. So I guess we're gonna take care of the other two first and then we'll try to down that one. So how are we gonna do this? Probably interesting thing to do would be the same which we did with the archer here, right? Just the other way around. Hey, that's not what I wanted. Yeah, okay, stay there. You're on attacking target. Put you on passive. Move you a bit closer so I can see you. And then we see if we can spot those guys through here. Or get them here so we can shoot them. Who's first? Hello. You. Gotcha. There you go. Come here. Hello? Come on, you're not even trying. Alright. Still the hard way. Ow. Hi. That works as well. Fine with me. Just stay there, come to you next. Headshot. Yeah, run away. I'll come back. Nope, they're still running away. better. Yeah, game. Thank you. You sleepy yet? Ow. Come over here. Yeah, that's better. Thank you. Perfect. Oh yeah, that's decreasing quite rapidly, so I'm gonna put those on there. I'll be back with you in a second. We need to get some food as well. So, thank God we have enough of our narcos, right? So, Froggy. Here, kitty kitty. Froggy, Froggy, where are you? You're stealth frog. You're not supposed to be a stealth frog. Come here. Now this is going to be dangerous, because this guy has quite some reach, and as you can see, it jumps, so it can jump up these rocks if we are really unlucky. So let's find the highest spot and see if we can actually hit that guy. Stop it! Stop running around. Nice plan. If it worked. Close. Close but no frog. What are you doing? Better. Better is good. Are you actually stuck there? That would be so nice. Frog, can you get stuck? Please? Yeah, reload. Run away. Hi. Ow. Ow. Don't make me pass out. Yeah. That's exactly what I meant. This guy is dangerous. Ooh, ah. Run away. Run away. Getting toppled quite rapidly here. Ooh, ah. It's not only dangerous, it's fast as well. Yeah, I'm going. Now, let's just get him away from the door. Don't really want to pass out right here. Can you come over here, please? What's it look like? We got 200 torpor. So, we'll see. Are you there? Hello? Can I actually see you somewhere? Using K-mode trick? Yes, I can. Can you come somewhere where I can shoot you? Popo doing. Going down. Perfect. Here. Right here. If you have two people, one can carry this frog with the flyer and the other one can shoot it. That works quite well. If you don't have two people, you're pretty much stuck with kiting the frog, hoping not to get shot. And it's getting dark, perfect. Am I 3.6? Am I hitting you? Are you mad at me? Yes, you are mad at me. Ow! By way! Here. Back up. Don't get hit. You are low level as you are. Don't need to decrease that even further. Hi. Move. Are you not interested in chasing me? That is weird. Back here. Oh, maybe I'm just not hitting. Don't getting any battle music. Hi. Well, that was definitely a hit. Yep, that was it. Hi. Don't get too close to that beaver. Oh, you just don't care. No, I am hitting you. That's what I thought. So, we got that one down. Yeah, we could use regular meat. I don't really want to do that. What about you? Popper going back up? Yeah, still. Great. I'm gonna give you just one more here. Now, where did I lose that frog? Somewhere over here. Same here. Oh, that's fine. Still have plenty of time there. So, let's see if we can get down that giant prehistoric elk without killing it. You're pretty much healed up, right? Now, if I stay out of range and this guy is stuck on that tree, it shouldn't move. It should not attack that tree. And thus it will not get unstuck. There you go. You're trying to run away? Of course you're trying to run away. You just can't run. Oh, I thought I had him there for a second. It twitched! It twitched! Now, I'm not gonna make a pun around Twitch. This egg is not streaming. So... Patrick! Three down. Now, let me go and get some food. I get back once these guys are, well, either done taming or close to done taming. Well, that was faster than I expected. I just came back with the prime meat. So, let's see. You're working on it. Food is already back to full. So this guy obviously takes berries, vegetables, or kibble. Same here. So you get those. Give it 10 for starters. So one of these does 40, 5 of them is 200, 10 of them is 400. Just fed it 10. Was way too much, doesn't really matter. Grab these while trying to grab something else, so we get rid of that. Hi! 143, you were 96, right? Oh, yeah, right. SPG 96, 143. Thank you. Come here. And stay here, and I'd say passive for everybody. Yeah, I brought back the Argentavis, jumped on the Rex, went over there, and killed a couple of Argentavis. That's a good thing of having a mostly carnivore spawn point over there. So, you definitely need 400. Don't need that. Well, just keep it. Resource is resource, right? So, how are you looking? You're herbivores. You're getting the best berries I have, although vegetables would be way better. Which means you're going to take ages to tame up. Especially you, level 116. Not so much the level 56 over here. They're gonna take some time. You're gonna take an excessive amount of narcotics. Well, didn't expect the frog to be up with just 4 bites, but that's what it is. Yeah, it's around about 4 bites. Give me that. Keep the rest. You could need some regular meat. Fortunately, we have more than enough of that. Byproduct of Argentavis farming. Same as all the rest. So, I'm gonna stay here. Take care of these two, and I meet you right back once our hat trick is complete. Oh, this guy is a pain to tame. Already threw a stack of narcotics, almost. And as you can see, this is going down rather quickly. That's about 200, so that's another 5 to get it back up to the top. It's quite good actually that this guy needs berries and not meat, because berries, you know, you only need to go down 30 instead of 50. So yeah, that definitely works in our favor here. It just takes ages. Halfway done. This guy is obviously done. This guy is almost done. That looks good. And as you can see, we don't need nearly as many narcotics here. Well, let's take that off. We don't need that. So, while these are taming up, would you please move? Thank you. While these are taming up, let's talk about these three guys a little bit more. Let's use the time wisely and actually talk some strategy. As you can see, I made the saddles. Learned the engrams. We had enough points. So, no issue there. What level are we? 66 and still 120 points to go. So, we should be able to make the quest saddle fairly soon. Yeah, we can actually learn that if we want to right now. Can't do this one yet, because we're not yet level 80. It would be beneficial. We definitely need that to get the next quest. So, let's talk about strategy. What are we going to do with these guys? This guy... What are we going to level? We need melee damage for this one. We're going to take our Argentavis, put this guy on aggressive, carry it around, find a quest, get close to its neck, and then have this guy attack that quest. Inducing torpor and flying away quite often and coming back quite often as to not damage it too much while torpor rises, we hope to get the quetz down to the ground unconscious before we kill it. Gonna take a low level quetz for that, that's all we need for the moment. That's what we're gonna do. What else can we use this guy for? Well, before the patch with the beavers, where they actually produced dams where we could get all the cementing paste we wanted, this was the best method of getting cementing paste. You just go to the swamp, kill Meganurus, Titanomurnus, all the bugs there are, and harvest cementing paste straight from their corpses by just, you know, attacking them. And since this guy has two attack modes, one is the long tongue which you use to attack us. She? Yeah, again, she. Okay, you're she as well, right? And I think that's actually our first male over there. The second mode is a cleaving swipe, if you wish. It's not that long range, but you get pretty much everything in the near vicinity. Gamma up. What am I doing? This one. Gamma 3.6 should be fine. Put that away. So yeah, definitely quetz taming, and then cementing pass paste farming. So if you're on a multiplayer server with about 100 slots, there's a high chance that you won't find any beaver dams, because everybody else will have looted them already. So this is your, well, go-to dinosaur slash animal, I guess. Mammal? Not a dinosaur, really. Reptile? Somebody tell me in the comments. To get cementing paste, that's what we're gonna do. The only other option to get cementing paste is using stone and chitin slash keratin, which means you need to kill scorpions, carnos, stegos, everything that gives you some kind of horn or... outer shell slash armor, so scorpions is your best bet, usually. This guy? Well, that's our thatch machine. Now you can use other animals to get thatch, no problem with that. It's just this guy, you can attack while running. You don't need to slow down. So you can run through a forest, well, like this, or the little forest over there. Or anything we have up there, you can just keep on running, attacking the trees, and get all the thatch you want. So, in the end, in the long run, this guy is faster than anything else I've seen currently in ARK. This guy, we already talked about the speed. Look at this. Get all of that. Where are we? 800, that's 700. So, 600 is 15. We already gave it 5. Let's give it another 10. That's going quick. This guy will get all the wood we want. I've already said that this guy will gather wood, first of all, at an astonishing rate, and second of all, it can store a lot of wood. So what we also could do is we could take our Argentavis or our Quetz, if we make that a weight quest, carry this guy around to other beaver dams, then just get rid of the beavers, which an Argentavis can do fairly quickly by just picking them up and killing them in the air, or, well, the quests can do the same, just killing them by flying over them, and then we can get to those beaver dams, which usually hold about 500, 600 wood. We just take all that wood, put it in there, and carry it back home, as wood doesn't weigh as much in this guy. What are we currently? 360? If we pack this guy full of wood, the maximum amount it will weigh is about these 360. Well, let's say this goes up to 500, so we have 500. 500 is nothing for a Quetz or an Argy. Our Argy currently has a weight of 700, I believe. And a Quetz should start around a ton and a half. So that's fairly easy to do. We could even get another one of those, or three or four, build a structure on a Quetz platform saddle, like an enclosure, put them all in there. Fly to those beaver dams, get all the wood we want, stuff it in there, those guys, while they are being transported by the quests. So we only have, I think it's a tenth of the weight, or at least a fifth of the weight. So we can get five times as much wood as we could if we were just flying around with the quests carrying the wood itself. So there's a lot of strategies and options. Rain! Thank you. That we could use to benefit of these three creatures. Now, first thing we want to do is definitely use this one to get a quest, and I'm thinking we are trying to do that right next episode. While I was flying around, I found a number of them. All of them level 12, level 20, level 28. I found 104. It's over there behind the snow biome. We need to find that one again once our quests, our first quest is tamed and we have a platform saddle. Because then we're going to build a quest trap on that platform saddle and just trap the other one in midair and trank it right on our quests. Now, if you haven't seen how that works, you're happily invited to watch any of the videos where somebody does that, or wait until we get there. It won't be too long, like 3-4 episodes maybe. And then we have our big quests, which will be our weight quests. And the one we're going to tame first might be our speed quests. Now, you're not coming over here, otherwise I have to kill you. I told you not to attack us. Don't say I didn't warn you. Arr. This whole taming has been taking about 80 minutes. There you go. SPG 56, now 82. It's not too bad. So let's have a look at the stats. 900 health. Yeah, okay. 380 weight, we need to work on that. Melee damage could be a little bit higher, but nah, doesn't really matter. Movement speed is good. Oxygen is nice, makes it swim faster in the water. Food, yeah, nobody cares. Stamina, doesn't need that much as far as I know. Now, saddle on, as you can see, all our smithy stuff, let's do it this way, is right here. Well, that will save us a lot of time, because we can actually take this guy down here. And now we need to build some more stuff we can't build in our inventories, like these. Won't need them that often, but still good to have here. We can do that right here. It's gorgeous. So, you are following me, right? Get up here. Now, everybody follow me. And we're gonna go back home. That didn't work. So, let's have a look at the stats of the others. We had that one. Add you. What about you? Definitely need to work on weight a little bit, but since it's only thatch gathering and we are going to check out everything else, thatch doesn't weigh that much. So that's good. We want melee damage to harvest more resources from the same trees. Movement speed. Yeah, we don't really need that because it's not supposed to be fast. It's supposed to be running through the wood, getting everything there is to get. And if it's too fast, we're going to skip half the trees, right? Need more health, need more stamina, so this is what we're going to focus on, like 5,000 health and maybe 3,000 stamina, so then we can actually get a real load. We have to stop quite frequently with this way to chuck out the wood and the berries and all the other stuff, so it will regain stamina while we're doing it. Not much to worry about. You actually killed that Argy. Nice. More melee. More melee means more torpor. And now we're going to go home. You coming? Everybody's coming. Good. So, Zoom, 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 zoom. With this lovely picture of the day, I say goodbye. That's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more, leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. See you soon. Yay!